Okay, hello and welcome back. I hope you have seen my third video on this chapter, that is elasticity of demand, where I have explained you some basic concept from this chapter. So today we are going to continue with this chapter and we are going to see some more concept on this chapter. But before that, let us quickly revise the things that we have done so that we should not miss anything. So we have first seen that the concept was given by Alfred Marcel and the meaning of elasticity of demand. Then demand function, the different types of elasticity, where we have where I have told you that what is the meaning of price elasticity, income elasticity, cross elasticity and advertising elasticity, where we have discussed about price elasticity. And I hope I remember that we have discussed till that we were discussing about the degree of price elasticity of demand, right? So this is what actually the third slide that shows us the meaning of the price elasticity. And one example we have discussed, you can see here, this was the example that we have discussed about price elasticity, and this is the formula of finding price elasticity. Okay, so moving on further, so we have also seen three different method of finding price elasticity. One is called percentage method, and this is the derivation of the formula delta Q by delta P into P by Q. And then expenditure method, I told you to, for time being, you remember this table so that you can give answer from the chapter X, from if the question come from this part, that is expenditure part. Then we have seen the third method of finding elasticity, that is called point method or geometrical method, and the formula that we use here is lower segment by upper segment. So this is what we have seen, and this was the second last slide that we have discussed in the first video, where I was trying to explain you the degree of price elasticity. I told degree means nothing, but actually it is some values of price elasticity that we were talking about. And this was the last slide that we have discussed in the first video, where I have told what is the meaning of the perfectly inelastic, and a little bit of some examples with the help of a table and the demand curve that I have shown you in the third video. And this is the value of elasticity of price elasticity of demand in case of perfectly inelastic demand. So today class, we are going to start from here, and we are going to find out some more values or degree of price elasticity. So you can see here in this slide, the second I may say this is this is called perfectly elastic demand. So let me first read this, and so that I can make you understand in a better way what is perfectly elastic means. It is told when consumers are prepared to purchase all that they can get at a particular price, but nothing at all at a slight higher price. This is the case of perfectly elastic demand. Right. So we generally see that this is a case which is generally fine in case of a highly luxurious good, where with a change in the price, a little bit change in the price, the consumer may deny to buy anything, or the consumer may buy any quantity of the commodity. So that is what actually a case of perfectly elastic demand. OK, so you can see here, in case of perfectly elastic demand, we see the value of price elasticity is infinite. We do not know what is the value of price elasticity. It can be anything. And this is the demand curve. If I explain you the demand curve, I hope you can get some more idea about what is perfectly elastic. I'm using the word perfectly elastic. You can see here in this diagram, the quantity demanded is taken in the horizontal axis and the price is taken in the vertical axis. And the demand curve is a horizontal line like this. It shows that when a price is P1, see, when the price is P1, the demand may be Q1, the demand may be Q2. So the demand can change, but the price is not changing, just opposite to the first case. You remember in this first case, I told the price is changing, but the demand is not changing. And in this case, I'm telling that in this case, that is perfectly elastic demand, demand is changing. Demand may be anything, but the price remains same. And if the price changes little bit, say suppose if the price increased from P1 to anything else, we may find that the demand curve does not even exist for that commodity. So that is the reason that why we are saying that if the price rises slightly, there can be any change in the demand. So this is a case of perfectly elastic. We do not find this situation also in real life. So it is very difficult to find out this situation in a real life, but still this is a concept, and we have to go through this concept. Okay, so let me go to the third degree, and let's see what actually the third degree degree is telling. The third degree is known as unit elastic demand. So this is again one more value of elasticity, unit elastic or unitary elastic. Unitary elastic is nothing but what we say when the value of elasticity of demand is equal to 1. That is a case of unit elastic. I'll make you understand what is actually the unit elastic means. Unit elastic means that if the price of any commodity changes by say X unit, then the demand of that commodity will also change by X units. To be simple, what I'm trying to say, I'm trying to explain that when the price of the commodity increase by 2 unit, then the demand is going to fall by 2 units. So the magnitude of change in price as well as in demand is same. Of course, following the law of demand, if the price will rise, the demand will fall. But the point is, what is the magnitude of change? The price is rising by 2 unit and at the same time the demand is falling by 2 units. So if this is a case that change in price and change in demand is same, then that is a case of unit elastic demand curve. So this is what, and what we get, if you look here, the two demand curve I have drawn, where one demand curve is a rectangular hyperbola. Actually, we say that when the value of elasticity is equals to 1, the demand curve is a rectangular hyperbola. It simply means that this area, the C, initially the price was P1 and the price was P1 here, and the price reduced to P2. As a result, what we see that initially the quantity was Q1, and since the price has reduced, so we know following the law of demand, the quantity has increased. But the point is, rectangular hyperbola here implies that this area is equals to this area, that is change in price is equals to change in quantity. So this is my change in price and this is my change in quantity. So in case of rectangular hyperbola, this two is same. So that whenever a question comes that what is the shape of the demand curve when the value of elasticity is equals to 1, we draw a rectangular hyperbola curve, or what we can do, we can draw a downward sloping line making an angle of 45 degree from the base, because we know that a downward sloping line making an angle of 45 degree implies that perpendicular by base is same, using that trigonometrical concept, that is perpendicular by base, tan theta equals to perpendicular by base. So that is what actually unit elastic demand is in the concept. And of course, real life example, I cannot say there is any real life example related to unit elastic demand where the change in price is equal to the change in quantity. Again, that situation may arise where the change in price may be equal to change in quantity, but there is no particular example to it. So that is what the third degree of price elasticity of demand. Moving on to the next, you can see here, that is elastic demand. This is a real life situation and we can talk about this a little longer, right? So let me tell you what is this elastic demand. You can see here the definition is written that when percentage change in quantity demand of a commodity exceed the percentage change in price, that is a case of elastic demand. To be simple, what do I mean? I mean that elastic demand is nothing but the degree of responsiveness of a consumer is much more than the change in the price. So if that is a situation, then that situation is called elastic demand. You can see here with the help of the demand curve also, I have tried to show what actually I am telling here, that you can see when the price was P1 initially, the quantity demand was Q1. When the price increased, the demand has reduced to Q2. But the point is that change, how much change? So you can see with the arrow mark, the prices, the magnitude of change in price is shown, and this arrow is smaller than this arrow because the change in quantity demand is bigger. So in case of elastic demand, what we see that the demand curve is flatter in shape. The more the flatter flatter the demand curve will be, the more elastic the behavior of the consumer. That means what I'm trying to say, the more the consumer are going to respond. Again, I'm reminding you, I told you that elastic means response, and response here does not imply whether a consumer is happy or sad. Response here imply that whether how much quantity of change is there in the basket of the consumer. That means how much commodity there is a change in the purchasing of the consumer. That is what actually elastic means. I hope I have told you in my third video of this chapter. So that is what a case of elastic. And okay, let us have a discussion on this picture. picture also, because it seems very interesting to tell you that what is the case of elastic demand. You can see here, let us take this as a first situation. See, when the price of cola, that can be anything, we can take the example of Coca-Cola also. So when the price of cola was around $3, this person is telling forget it. Forget it means he do not want to buy because he find the price is very high. For one bottle of cola, if I have to pay $3, that price is very high and therefore I am not going to buy it. So it is told that forget, the person is telling here forget it. But the point is, when the price reduced, when the price reduced to $1, now the point, see how many bottles this person is carrying. This person is carrying so many bottles, so that and he is telling that good price, he is selling good price, and he is buying many bottles, and initially he was not buying any of the bottle. So that shows that when price is changing, see, when $3 to $1, that means change of $2, 3 minus 1 is 2, but the point is he was not buying any single bottle, but here I can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and many bottles he is buying. So that shows the consumer is responding too much when there is a change in the price for the cola. So that shows the demand, the nature of elasticity of demand for this cola bottle is actually elastic in nature. So when the producer are going to reduce the price, the consumers are going to respond by buying more of it. So that is what actually the meaning of elastic demand. Okay, so let us move on to the next slide to understand some more degree, that is called inelastic. I hope I told you what is the case of inelastic. Inelastic means the responsiveness of the consumer is very less. Or let me first go through this definition, and then I hope I can make you understand better what is the meaning of the word elastic demand. You can see here, it is told when percentage change in quantity demand of a commodity is less than the percentage change in price. That means this is a situation opposite to the first situation that we have discussed just now. That is the previous slide. You can see the previous slide is elastic demand. So this is a situation where we are telling that inelastic demand means when the price will change, demand will also change. But change in demand will be less than the change in price. So price is going to change more and the demand is going to change less. So this is generally a case with a necessity good. So in case of necessity good, what we see that when the price changes, so suppose when the price increase, we do not have much option to respond. And since we do not respond much, that means we cannot change the quantity of the commodity that we were purchasing. And since we cannot change the quantity of the commodity that we were purchasing, so this is a situation of inelastic, because we are not responding much to change in the price. And if you look here, the demand curve in case of inelastic, then you can see here it is steeper in nature. The first one I have told it is flatter, and here I am telling that it is steeper. So steeper demand curve implies that, or steeper demand curve represent inelastic demand. You can see here with some examples, that is say suppose when the price was 10, the demand was this, and the price increased, the demand when the price will increase, the demand has reduced. But the point is, you see the price is changing from 10 to 14. That is around 40% change in the price, and at that time the quantity demand is changing from 88 to 80. That is, it is written about around 10%. So that means the price is changing by 40%, whereas the demand is changing by only 10%. So percentage change in quantity demand is less than the percentage change in price. This is a case of inelastic demand. And again, we are not going to miss the fear diagram, that is the one picture here. So let us have a look on this picture, and then we can understand the case of inelastic demand in a better way. You can look here, see here, that is I can say just have a look here, that is this. So when this is the first situation, when the price of milk was around $0.80. So when the price of milk was around $0.80, the lady was going to the mall and she was buying some packets of milk. But the point is, when the price increased to $2.44, that is, there is a too much increase in the price, still the lady is buying the milk, and he's saying that, but I still need it. I still need it. That means she does not have the other options. There is no substitute of milk, and therefore she cannot switch to that substitute, and she cannot respond to change in the price. So when price of milk is rising, she is not responding, and therefore this situation is a case of inelastic demand. So that is what actually inelastic demand means. So this is what so we have seen many different degrees of elasticity. Let me just quickly show you. So this was the first degree of elasticity that we have seen: perfectly inelastic, perfectly elastic, unitary elastic, elastic, and inelastic. And at the same time, I have shown in each slide that in each cases, the value of elasticity, when we are talking about inelastic, it implies that the value of price elasticity will come less than one. So suppose if the value of elasticity is a fraction, then that is a case of inelastic demand. Okay, so coming on to the next topic here, that is factor affecting price elasticity of demand. This is quite an important topic for all of us to understand, that what does the factor affecting price elasticity of demand means. That simply means, if I talk in a simple way, then it simply means that what are the situations or what are the things that affect the responsiveness of the consumer. That means whether the people can respond or whether they cannot respond. So if they can respond, that is a case of elastic demand. If they cannot respond, that is a case of inelastic demand. You can see here some point I have mentioned. I have one more slide on this, that is factors affecting demand. So this is again a very important question for section B, where long question, the question comes like this, that what are the factors affecting price elasticity of demand, or discuss the factors affecting price elasticity of demand. So let us begin with this topic to understand what are the factors that affect price elasticity of demand. You can see here the first point is availability of substitute, right? Very easy. See, I can make you understand with the examples here. So you can see one picture where Coca-Cola is fighting with Pepsi. Coca-Cola is fighting with Pepsi means these are the substitute to each other. So if I go to a shop and I want to have a soft drink, then if Pepsi is not available, I can go for Coca-Cola, and if Coca-Cola is not available, I can go for Pepsi. So these are substitute to each other. So they are fighting that who is going to capture the market. So but the point is, we want to find out the elastic nature of these two commodities. So the point that if the thing is here, the I have explained so many things that how availability of substitute affect the price elasticity, but I'll make you understand by giving some examples so that you can understand in a better way the meaning of it. The thing is that when we go to the market and when we know that there are substitute of some commodity, when there are substitute available in the market, we have the chance to respond. That means, I'll give you one more example. Suppose if I go to the market to buy Colgate and I find the price of the Colgate, Colgate company has increased the price of the Colgate. So I have a substitute available, that is Pepsodent or other toothpaste. So I can easily shift from Colgate to the other toothpaste. So therefore my degree of responsiveness is very high. So that implies that the elasticity nature of Colgate is elastic in nature. Elastic means high degree of responsiveness, and inelastic means less degree of responsiveness. So since substitute is available, I can respond and I can shift myself to some other good. So if substitute is available, elasticity will be elastic in nature. If substitute is not available, elasticity will be inelastic in nature, in case of necessity good. You can see here one more picture, that is medicine. So we generally say that we do not have any substitute to, if doctor prescribes some medicine, I cannot say that I can know this medicine is very costly, so I'll not have this medicine, I'll have some other medicine. Suppose if I have a fever, so I should eat paracetamol. I cannot say that I will have some other medicine that is used for some other purpose. So that is what the point is. The point is, in case of medicine, we do not have substitute, and hence the nature of elasticity of medicine is inelastic in nature. We cannot respond, the consumer cannot respond even if the price is changing. So that shows that if substitute is there, it is elastic. If substitute is not there, it is inelastic. Okay, so let us come to the second factor. What is the second factor that affects price elasticity? It is a nature of the commodity. Of course, nature of the commodity is the second important factor which affect the elasticity. And if it is a when we are talking about nature, generally there are two different nature of commodities that we are talking about. One is luxurious commodity that we find in the market, and the other is necessary commodities that we find in the market. Necessary commodities like salt or many other commodities are there which are very important for our day-to-day life. And when the price of such commodity changes, we cannot respond much. We cannot say that I will not consume salt when the price of salt will increase. And so we can say that the elasticity nature of salt is inelastic in nature, because I cannot respond by changing the quantity consumption of salt when the price of salt is rising. So to be simple, what I'm trying to say that for luxurious commodity, say suppose for air condition, so if the price of air condition will rise, I may postpone my consumption and say that I'll buy after 1 month or 2 months. So I'm postponing it. That means I'm responding it. So for luxurious item, we see that elasticity of demand is elastic, whereas for necessary commodity we see that elasticity is inelastic in nature. So that is what actually how the nature of the commodity affect the price elasticity. And of course, I'll go for the third point. You can see here the third factor which affect the elasticity is the proportion of income spent. I hope this is the point we have discussed in the first two video while I was explaining you the theory of demand, where I told there is another type of commodity what we say is a necessity but inexpensive commodity. I hope you remember that a normal good, inferior good, and necessity good but inexpensive. Necessity good but inexpensive, like matchbox or soap. You can see some examples I have given here. Soap is an example of that. Salt is an example of that. Matchbox is an example of that. So what basically I'm trying to say that these are the commodity which are necessity or which are necessary for our life, but they're not very expensive, or the amount of or the part of our income which is spent on these goods are minimum, or I may say it's very less, so we do not bother much about it. So this is a case where the elasticity will be inelastic in nature. So what I'm trying to say that if the price of matchbox changes, suppose what is the price of matchbox in the market? In the market we get the matchbox at a price of ₹1. So if the price change by 50 paisa or 1 rupee more, suppose if the price get double, that is two rupees, so we do not bother much about it, because from our income minimum portion is changing. So therefore we do not respond more in commodities like this. So what we say that for commodities like this, where the proportion of income spent is very less, the nature of elasticity of this commodity is inelastic in nature. So that is what actually we do not bother. But if I'm talking about, say, commodities like or services like education, because education is getting expensive day by day. So when there is a change in the fees, the people respond much, because it is a part where the large part of our income is getting involved, and therefore we are very cautious about it, and we respond much when there is a change in the fees structure. So that is what actually the portion of income spent. So it explained that how this is a third important factor affecting the price elasticity of demand. Okay, so I hope you have understood these three points affect the price elasticity. Let me go for the next slide, where I'll make you understand three more factors that affect the price elasticity. This is something called number of uses of the commodity. That is again most important, number of use. You can see here I've taken one example. This is actually I can guess that none of you can identify what is this. This is actually a coal. This is a coal, and we know that coal is having a lot of uses. There are many uses of a coal. Coal can be used for cooking purpose. It can be used for it can be used in factory for in a furnace for melting metals, and many purposes of coals are there. The point is that when the price of coal is going to change, because coal is a commodity that have many uses. Similarly, milk is a commodity that also has many purposes. Milk can be used for making sweets, it can be used for making curd, it can be used for drinking purpose. So there are many use of milk. So that is what actually we are talking about. So we are here in this slide, in this topic, I'm talking about those commodity which have many uses. And when the price of these commodity changes, people respond much. Like, for example, when the price of milk or when the price, say electricity, the electricity is the best example to explain here. Electricity has many purposes. It can be used for cooking, lighting purpose, in a factory it can be used. So when the electricity become relatively costlier, or it become in the unit that we pay for electricity become very costly to us, then we are not going to use electricity for cooking. What we are going to use, that is the most urgent need, for lighting purpose. So that is what, so we are responding in the sense, now we are limiting the use of electricity when the price of electricity is rising. So that shows the responsiveness of the consumer. So in case of those commodity which have multiple uses, the nature of elasticity is elastic, and for those commodity which have only one uses, the nature of elasticity is inelastic in nature. Okay, I hope you have understood. Now there are two more factors. Let us quickly discuss these two factors. One is called time factor. That is again one of a very important factor affecting price elasticity. We say like this, that longer the time, larger is the response, and shorter the time, lesser is the response. So what actually I mean that what we see, that if we have sufficient time to respond, suppose if I want to buy something and I know that I have a sufficient time, I can go to the market, I can buy that commodity anytime, that then my degree of responsiveness will be high. Why I'm saying this? Suppose if I want to buy any commodity, and if I feel the price of the commodity is very high and I can buy it after 1 month, 2 months, or 1 year also, so I'll wait for the price to reduce so that I can buy that commodity. So I'm responding. But for some commodities where there is an emergency, I cannot wait for long, I have to buy, then in that case, even if the price is changing, I cannot change my demand, and I have to go to the market to buy the commodity. So because that is an emergency and I have to buy it right now. So that shows that when time, availability of time is there, the degree of responsiveness is high. So elasticity will be elastic in nature. And when time is short, the elasticity will be inelastic in nature. And finally, coming on to the last factor, that is your habit of the consumer, that also determine the price elasticity. You can see the point. It is told that if consumers are habitual of consuming some commodity, they will continue to consume these commodity even at a higher price. And I hope you can understand this definition from the picture that I have given here. I think you can all identify what is this picture is. This picture is of cigarette. And of course, one more picture here, that is the picture of a alcohol bottle. The point is, those who are smoker and those who are drunker, for them, no matter how much there is a change in the price of cigarette and how much is the price change in the price of a bottle of alcohol, they continue to consume it. So it shows that those person who are habituated of something, even if the price of the commodity changes, they do not change their demand, they do not respond much, and they continue consuming the same quantity of the commodity. So in this situation, we see that habit of the consumer is an important factor that affect price elasticity of demand. So we can say that if consumer are habituated of something, the nature of elasticity will be inelastic in nature. That means consumer cannot respond. And if suppose if a person is not habituated of something and he can shift his preference easily from one commodity to another commodity, for that those type of commodity, we say the nature of elasticity is elastic in nature. That means the consumer can respond much. So that shows that what are the factors. So let us quickly see what are the factors we have discussed. So availability of substitutes is a important factor. The nature of commodity is another important factor. Portion of income spent, number of uses of the commodity, time factor, and habit of the consumer. So these are the six important factors that affect the price elasticity of demand. And this is a table. You can see this is a small summary of what we have discussed so far, that will help you out to understand at a glance that what will be the nature of elasticity. You can see here, in case of availability, if there are several availability is there, if the commodities have substitute, it will be elastic. If it does not, then it is inelastic. For necessary commodity, it is inelastic. For luxurious commodity, it is elastic. So like this, this is a table that we have discussed so far. You can see from here at a glance, and you can see that what type of commodities and what is their nature of elasticity. So like this only. So suppose, for example, for time also I have shown that if it is a short run, it is inelastic, and if it is a long run, it is elastic. That means people can respond. So that is what. So today I'll end here. This is the second video of mine in this chapter, that is on the chapter elasticity of demand. I have to make one more video on this chapter because there are some more topics that we are left with in this chapter. So we'll continue in the third video. Thank you.